じゃあよろしくお願いします。
So thanks for having us. We'll walk right into it.
それではダーク2の、説明を、始めさせていただきます。
We'll take a little bit of time to introduce Dark Souls 2 to you.
まずダークソウル2で最初に目指したのは、グラフィッククオリティの向上です。
So one of the first things we immediately tried to improve in terms of Dark Souls 2 was the graphic quality of the game.
このタイトルで最も重要な要素の一つとして、没入感というものがありまして、その没入感を前作以上に高めるために今回グラフィックの、向上というのをまず第一の目標にして開発を進めています。
So one thing we really focused on, obviously for Dark Souls 1 and more so in Dark Souls 2 is how much you can get deep into the game emotionally and physically. And one of the things we thought was critical to that was the graphical improvements for more reality, more realistic expressions of everything we want to show in the game.
今作でも今、見ていただいたような篝火という要素は、残っております。
And obviously you just saw the bonfires, key aspect in the game which will remain in Dark Souls 2.
ここではダークソウルの、前作から引き継ぐ戦闘の部分を見ていただきます。
Right now what we're trying to show you a little bit about is the combat system that will carry on from Dark Souls 1 and Dark Souls 2.
ダークソウルの戦闘の特徴としてはシンプルで駆け引きのある戦闘という部分なんですけれども、それは今作でも健在です。
One of the underlying concepts for the combat system in Dark Souls is simple controls and sort of the trial and error and the strategic gameplay behind it, and that will commence throughout Dark Souls 2 as well.
ここはですね、下を覗くと下に炎のトカゲが見えるというシチュエーションです。
What we're trying to show you here is if you look down, you can see these lizard salamander type monsters down below.
このような立体的な構造を生かしたレベルデザインは今作も、前作を踏襲した作りになっています。
And what we really want to focus on and continue to express in Dark Souls 2 is the three-dimensional venue creation, environmental creation, so that you can really explore in depth.
ここは脇から突然死体だと思っていた兵士が起き上がってくるシチュエーションです。
So while this was a sort of a surprise attack, we thought one of the soldiers were dead, but he actually came back alive and attacked you.
次はちょっと新しい様子を見ていただこうかと思います。
This is something new we're trying to show you right now.
この先は闇なんですけども、ここで松明を灯すことで、光を持って先に進むことができます。
So you saw it was pitch black in the hallways, but if you go back and light a torch,You can actually see the flame light up the area that you want to walk through.
そうすると暗いところでもこのように突然出てきた敵に対処することができます。
So what then you can do is you can be prepared for any enemies that lurk out of the dark. You actually can see them before they actually kill you.
次は戦闘の一例としてリアクションというものをお見せしたいと思います。この敵は今見ていただいたように突然背中から後ろに回り込むと背中から倒れ込んで攻撃してきます。
This is an example of one of the battles that you want to have with the enemies. But what we're trying to express here is the reactions that the enemies will have. Right now you just saw that if you sneak in behind the enemies will properly react and sort of do this backdrop onto you. So they'll always be prepared to attack and kill you.
逃げたところ、囲まれてしまいました。
And you try to escape and now you're trapped in the dark.
で松明を盾に持ち替えようとしましたが、残念ながらやられてしまいました。
You tried to replace the torch with a shield. The torch went out, and obviously it was a little bit too late.
気を取り直してちょっともう一度、今度は別のルートを見ていただきます。
Alright, so now that we tried, let's try to take a different route and show you something else.
先ほどお見せしたのはリアクションの一例なんですけども、今作では、敵や、敵のリアクションというものに重きを置いて制作を進めております。
So that was an example of one of the reactions that the enemies will take and how you can interact directly with the enemies. That was just one example. We'll try to show you something a little bit different now.
そうすることでプレイヤーに多様な攻略方法が生まれると、そう考えております。
We feel that with the enemies having different types of reaction, different types of thought processes,it will allow the player to actually strategize and figure out for himself in terms of his best way of conquering each of the venues in the game.
次はもう一つその一例を見ていただきます。
So now we'll show you another example.
この先に行くと前方に でかい斧を持った敵が見えます。
So if you can see, look forward and you see a troll type character that has an enormous axe.
この敵の斧を弾いて投げ飛ばすことができます。が、今は2回目頭に刺さってやられてしまいました。
So you, if you're skilled enough, you can deflect away the axe. But obviously the second one hit you pretty hard there.
次は、もう一つのマップを見ていただこうかと思います。
Here's a different venue that we want to show you today.
ここは、竜の、館というマップでして、古竜の研究をしていたという設定のマップです。
So this name's still undetermined or undecided yet, but right now we're calling it the Mansion of the Dragons. It's a place where we set as an area where experiments had been done on dragons in the past.
ここでアイテムを取ると突然、ドラゴンが動き出しました。
Pick up that item. It's the dragon suddenly moving.
このマップは、一風変わったマップでして、敵が最初には一切出てこないという、特殊なシチュエーションです。
This venue itself has a unique characteristic in that.You're constantly lurking around, you're constantly being aware of enemies, but you're actually not faced up against any enemies immediately in this venue.
プレイヤーはいつ敵が出てくるのかという緊張感を持ちながら、進んでもらうようなことを意図しています。
Yeah, we want the players to be nervous, stressed, really careful in terms of walking around each corner, being aware of any enemies that come in. But, so we want that emotional nervousness and pressure that the players will hopefully feel.
ここにあるのが口の鍵というものでして、この口に石をはめ込むことで、この館の照明を作動させることができます。
So this is an item that will be placed throughout the game. It's sort of, we call it the key mouth, I guess. But if you place an item within the mouth, it will trigger certain events that happen in the game.
あの鍵は、他のマップの各所で使えるようになっていてですね、プレイヤーがどこで使うかっていうのを自分で選択して、こう攻略に役立てていくっていうものを、イメージしています。
So the item that you placed in the mouth of the stone, the item itself can be used in various parts of the venue, and it would be up to the user or the player to actually be able to decide and strategize in terms of when you want to use a certain item for which situation.
ここまで来てもまだ敵が出ないんですが、ここで見るとなんか大型の敵が扉の向こうに見えます。
So you haven't been able to face any enemies up to this point, but if you look through the gates there, you can see something pretty big in the background.
ちょっとこいつに攻撃をしてみます。
So what we'll do is we'll take our bow and arrow and try to target, see what happens.
弓矢で頭を打つと、暴れ始めました。
You shot him in the head, so he's pretty upset now.
そして壁を壊して襲いかかってきます。
So, now in this game, enemies will actually break the wall and try to get back in.
これも、リアクションの一例でして、このようにプレイヤーが何かアクションを起こすことで、マップや敵が豊富なリアクションを返してくるというのを、本作では主眼に置いています。
So this is another example of the reactions of the enemies that we were talking about earlier. If you didn't shoot him, maybe he wouldn't do anything, but because you did shoot him, He does seem a little bit upset, and you'll react accordingly.
ちょっとこの先も見せしたいんですけど、このマップは、今日はちょっとここまでにさせていただきます。
We actually want to move a little bit forward and show you a little bit more, but for today, I think we'll keep it at this, and we'll show you a little bit more of something else.
次は各マップの、いろんなシチュエーションや、死に方のバリエーションというのを見ていただきたいと思います。
So now we'll walk into is some more.Information for you guys in terms of how the player will die or what the player will experience in terms of troubles throughout the game.
ここはトレーラーにも出てきた、竜の祭祀場というシチュエーションです。
So this is another area in the map. We actually showed a little bit of this in some of the trailer footage that we may be showing you, but it's sort of a castle of a dragon.
奥に向かって進み始めると、竜、ワイバーンたちが騒ぎ始めます。
So as you try to cross this bridge, you see the wyverns are all of a sudden getting upset. They're all acting up.
前方に落ちだったワイバーンが飛び立った時に橋が崩れて落ちてしまいました。
And the wyvern landed on the bridge and flew off, and obviously the bridge broke and you died. And it's a terrible way of dying, and it seems like you have no choice, but we will have a way for you guys to conquer this area.
次はこれは拷問場というシチュエーションで、前方から迫ってくるのはシルバーチャリオッツというボスキャラです。
This is sort of a torture chamber that we're showing right here, and the guy that sort of ran you over, we call him the Silver Chariot right now.
本作で最も重要だと思っているのは、死の多様性というところでして、それが何のためにあるかというと、プレイヤーがいろんな死を乗り越えたことに達する達成感を味わってほしいと、そういうところを重視してダークソウル2というのは開発をしております。
One thing we really focus on for Dark Souls 2 is the variety of deaths that the player will be able to experience throughout the game. And the reason why we want to put a lot of variations inThe types of death, types of situations is for, again, for the players to really feel that sense of satisfaction when you overcome certain obstacles. And with all these variations in the types of deaths that the player will be able to face, hopefully when you get over each of them, the sense of satisfaction and the fist clenching is something that will be rewarding to the players as they get throughout the game.